What's good, YouTube? Back at it again. We got into Kugu. Please like and subscribe. Oh, I just saw like a figure from next door. My bad. Really distracted me. Anyway, my next review is Netflix The Outsiders. I may be biased on this thing because I'm a big Jared Leto fan. He's like my second favorite actor. He's not better than Tom Hardy, though. It's just the way he acts. The way his voice comes out, it was just a marvel to see. His performance alone, but the story was so beautiful. Like, I advise people, if you haven't watched The Outsider, because of the credits, of all the negativity, even though it's obvious it's called The Outsider, and people are mad that it's a white dude joining the Yakuza, and it's obvious he's a gaijin, man. Let him be. That movie is amazing. It was beautiful. The aesthetics, the cinematography, the directing, it was such a period piece, man. Like first I thought they were just gonna put us in a situation where we find this dude in prison and he joins the Yakuza. Then his past started catching up to him and how he handled that, how his future was determined later on. It was just an amazing story. Japanese driven to the max. I really need to learn Japanese. I really love Japanese culture. It's all about the respect. That was a low blow, but anyway, really enjoyed it. Everybody's performance was amazing. It even made me want to rock a suit. You know, it's amazing when you watch a movie and it makes you want to adapt some things into your own life. That's how that movie felt to me. Like, on the real, I give it like a 7 out of 10. It's like not perfect. Like I said, it just throws you in. Like the first act, you're basically trying to understand why he's here, why is this happening, why is he there, and all these questions that are not really answered. Like all the questions that everyone makes you question don't really get answered, which is not satisfactory, you know. Like also the ending, it's like, are we getting a sequel? But because of the backlash, are we not? Because I want to know where it goes on. He got bow. He looks like he's in charge of the other, you know, group of the Yakuza. Like, it just got deep. I mean, like, the Japanese traditions were nice. I didn't know that the Yakuza cut their finger for each person they kill from the opposing team if they want to make amends. I didn't know things like that. It makes me want to go back and look at the history of the Yakuza. I see this very brutal and classic suicide. I say classic, I don't know why I phrased it like that, but it just makes me want to know. I really want to go to Japan one day and just experience it all, because it seems such an animated, beautiful place. Like, let me go back to my boy Jared Leto, the Joker himself. I really enjoyed this Joker too, for those who are interested to know. Yeah, I think there's more to it there. I'm not saying it was perfect, but I feel like there's more we can tackle through there. It's more about what that Joker represents than what he should represent, you know? Because, I mean, like, he has a past in Batman. I can't wait for that moment where Ben Affleck, if he's still signed on, meets Jared Leto's Joker. The history they have with the Robin dead, with this, that. I mean, he's already the king of Gotham. Now I'm just going left field on the movie I'm actually talking about. Anyway, really enjoyed the movie. Jared's performance was amazing. I loved how most of his performance was reacting this time to show how great he is as an actor, because he had less lines than everybody else. Even in between dialogues, I'll see other characters talk more than he does. Like, he'll just observe. I'm a very observant person, so I like observing people who realize the predicament, who think it down, who sit down and be logic, because it seems like every step he took was planned, pre-planned. He didn't just act, except the end when they shot his leg. That was the only time he was acting, you know, impulsively, in my opinion. Everything seemed like a strategy from then on. Oh yeah, even in prison at the beginning when he was helping the dude who's getting hanged. I forgot their names, I'm sorry, but yeah, when it was happening. Those are the only two impulsive things I saw him do in the whole. No, three. Also when he chopped that dude's head off, or neck, cut his neck, because he looked like he chopped it away. He went so fast, it was kind of like, what? Oh, it was just an amazing movie. Like I said, 7 out of 10. It wasn't perfect, because still a lot of unanswered questions. Hope it gets sequels, so we dive into more of this world. And I watched it without subtitles, so it was hard to keep up. I think my Japanese anime fan boy side was lucky that he could read mannerisms and he understood some words, because I was like, wow, basically 70% of this movie is in Japanese and there's no subtitles. So I'm hopefully gonna watch it again with subtitles to appreciate every distinct thing. But without the subtitles, already, I give you a 7 out of 10, so really check it out. Like and subscribe. I hope you like my review. Thank you. I'm just gonna go back to watching more stuff. Deuces before work life tomorrow. Well, internship life. I ain't gonna get paid.